It's the Arizona Golf Association Rule of the Month, brought to you by the Thompson Group. Let's be honest, golf fans, not every golf shot ends up on target. For those times that we have to drop a ball, knowing how to proceed under the new USGA rules is half the battle. When it comes to talking rules, there's none better than longtime USGA rules official and Arizona Golf Association Executive Director, Ed Gowan.
It's time for another Rule of the Month. Today we're going to talk about the Universal Relief Procedure that runs through all of the rules.
This procedure for dropping your ball covers all instances of free or penalty relief. Let's say your golf ball embeds in the fairway, ends up on a cart path, or dies in the desert. Listen up, all you toss and go and foot wedge guys, we're talking to you.
Me?
The new procedure creates an easy to understand area to drop your ball.
You've embedded your ball in the center of the fairway. You get free relief. Your reference point is immediately behind where the ball's embedded. You use the longest club in your bag. You measure a club length, not near the hole. That turns out to be a semicircle. That's where you can drop and play the ball from. But it can't be the putter. So the guys out there with the long putters, they're gonna have to use another club.
Like Ed said, it's a free drop for embedded balls in the fairway. Now just make sure you drop it right.
How to drop the ball. Now this is universal. There are no exceptions to this.
You no longer have to stand tall with your arms straight out and drop from shoulder height.
You simply drop the ball straight down from knee height.
As long as the ball doesn't hit you on the way down and comes to rest inside the relief area, it's in play, hit away. If for some reason the drop ball won't stay in the relief area, like you're on a hillside or something, you get two attempts, then you're allowed to place it.
The only time a player could get in trouble dropping the ball correctly is if he puts something in place to keep the ball from rolling a certain place or takes an action like stopping the ball. At that point, you've influenced a ball that's in play. You'll end up with a two-stroke penalty, and that would be called cheating.
The main thing to understand here is the designation of the half-circle relief area. Got it?
Got it.
Okay, let's talk about those balls that come to rest on the cart path. Don't fret, it's a free drop, but your relief area might not be a full half-circle.
You get free relief. I find my nearest point of relief. That's my reference point. I get a half circle with the longest club in the bag, as long as I don't go back on the path, so it could be part of a pie slice that's less than a half circle. That's my relief area. I drop the ball in that area.
So those are some one club length examples. What about two club lengths?
There are two instances in the rules, and only two. When you're taking relief from a lateral penalty area, marked red, you get two club lengths, semicircle, up to the line. So it could end up being a pie slice as opposed to a full half circle, depending on the direction you're going.
It's also two club lengths anytime you have an unplayable ball.
Let's say in the desert, you're in a cactus, you get two club lengths, half circle, not near the hole, and you drop and play the ball from that area.
All right, guys, the takeaway here is the new half circle relief area. Find your reference point. Depending on your situation, it's one or two club lengths, longest club in your bag, no closer to the hole, and remember, sometimes your relief area ends up less than a half circle.
Now you know the new universal relief procedure for getting a ball back in play the right way.
This has been your Arizona Golf Association Rule of the Month, brought to you by the Thompson Group.